r/AskReddit by Planet Reddit. Teachers of Reddit. What was the juiciest gossip you've heard from students while in the classroom? A couple of weeks ago, one of my second graders was crying, so some of the other kids in the class went over and asked what was wrong. Turns out her parents were getting a divorce because her dad was messing around with four other women and one of them is having another baby. Those were her exact words. I don't even want to know what else that poor kid had to overhear. Sounds like she may need a hug. I teach kindergarten. One student a few years back was acting off. Super hyper and behaving in ways she never had. When asked if she had taken her peanut butter at home, code for her ADHD medicine, as it was administered in a spoonful of peanut butter, she told us that her mom sold all of her peanut butter to some guy in their trailer park named Steve. Damn. That's just sad. Oh my god. Not juicy. Just silly. Good kid stayed after class to show me his anime drawings. Haha. And started rambling about his family dynamics. He told me that his parents are still very much in love and are often go on dates. Sweet. Then he told me that there's a rule in the house that if the master bedroom door is closed, you are to stay far away and never interrupt. Sometimes they'll be in there for hours. Haha. Haha. By the change in expression on his face, I could tell he just figured it out. Even if it's gross, I think it's cute. Too common for people to get stuck in dead bedrooms. I'm glad for them. A middle schooler thinking it's gross is understandable. Watch an adult's face when you tell them gonorrhea is spreading at the nursing home grandma's at and they should talk to her. Now that's hilarious. I posted this before, but it fits better here. I was in the back of the room looking for something in a cabinet. Two girls were having a conversation. Oblivious I was there. Girl 1, so they like have sex at a party? Girl 2, all the time. It's called swinging. They think I don't know, but I found stuff on my dad's computer. Girl 1, that's so weird. Girl 2, right? I have to go spend next weekend at my grandma's because there's going to be a party at my house. You just reminded me of my friend's aunt and uncle. I was really close to my best friend's grandfather. And he passed away, so I was in town, lived about 45 minutes away with my boyfriend, for the funeral. I don't drive. So after the funeral, my friend's aunt and uncle volunteered to give me a ride home. On the way, they told me in detail about their swinging lifestyle. They called it playing. 10 years later, I think they saw me as the alternative punk chick that I dressed myself up to be and were trying to drop hints that they wanted to have sex with myself and my boyfriend. I was 19 and they were in their mid-40s. Ro. Not a teacher. But I do volunteer for a middle school. Anyway. One of the students, a 6th grader, had sent a video of herself nude to a boy she liked. The boy had brought his phone to school the next day and showed everybody he talked to. He also had sent it to a group chat that had his whole class. The police had to come to the school to investigate. The girl was taken out of school by her parents. And the boy was expelled. Goddamn. When I was in middle school, we only had two girls that would make out for $5 with each other. $5 each. Or in total? My first grader once came to school and told me that daddy drank too much last night and mummy made him sleep in the bathtub. Another told me about the pubic hair grooming habits of her mother. I've never gotten horrible gossips from my young students. But parents, be aware. Your family secrets are not secrets if your young kids know. When we were nervous doing things in front of crowds, in a class play or dance recital or something, my dad would say, just imagine everyone is in their underwear. He basically meant pajamas, and to us the meaning was understood. Just imagine them wearing silly things and then it gets much less stressful. However, my little brother, who was about 5 at the time, said to my little sister's dance teacher, my dad imagines you in your underwear. Apparently she gave my dad a super grossed out look whenever he went to pick up my sister at dance after that. Lol. When I was young and my mom was pregnant with my little sister, they used to joke between themselves that the mailman was the father. One day the mailman rang the door to drop off a package that wouldn't fit in the box. And my older brother, like 10 at the time, answered the door. My mom walking up behind him. Mailman saw her and was like, you're expecting. Comma. And my older brother said very loudly, my dad says it's yours. My mom is a teacher. She said her students complained how the math teacher passed gas in front of them. The students laughed, which infuriated the teacher, and she told them if nobody would take responsibility for it, she would keep the class after school because it was not her that farted. None of the students took responsibility for the loud, noisy smell, so the students missed their buses that day. If it's between being the center of attention for something embarrassing in middle school and walking home, I am walking. 300%. Smart move by the kids. I'm a teacher at a secondary school in Australia. I've farted in class before and watched kids blame each other. I've even seen kids take credit for my fart. Oh boy. A girl's mom had been renting out a storage unit and using it to have sex with her daughter's boyfriend. The girl and her BF were only together because the mom suggested it to the boy, so he could hang around her without any questions about it. When it came out, her parents got divorced and her dad died in a drink driving accident a month later trying to cope with it all. Really messed up. Poor girl. Only left with a shitty parent. What the duck? Heard this from a teacher. About 10 years there was apparently an orgy on campus during lunch. It was 4 girls, 6 guys. They got caught ducking in the garden shed when the TA, also a student, went to get stuff ready for the next day. Word got around as a rumor at first until people who had walked by during the deed heard what was going. Confirmed it was true. The 2 seniors, both 18, almost got time in prison and almost registered as sex offenders, as 2 of the girls were 9th graders. That's wild. Row. Story of a friend who is also a teacher. I don't hold a candle to this one. Students were passing notes in class. This is 8th grade, US. After about a month they become comfortable and it started to interfere with class, so it got to point where he confiscated it. The students panicked. And really panicked. Said they apologize and told him to just throw it away. He said he'll decide later and kept it. He did read it. And a group about 8 students, half boys and half girls, would rotate sexual partners for only anal sex because they wanted to keep their virginity. This is their idea. He ended up having a conference with the parents one-on-one and it was a rough rest of the year. Round robin tournament style. Yikes. Plot twist. The boys realized they didn't need the girls. The juiciest gossip was always about fellow staff. One of my students, 11th grade, came to school and told me she'd ran into my boss in the weirdest situation that weekend. Turned out, my student was dating and sleeping with another student. That second student lived with his mother, who had recently separated from the father after the mom was caught cheating. The man she was cheating with was my boss, who was still married. My student had run into him as they were both sneaking out of the same house early on Saturday morning. Turned out to all be true. I would love to see process of realization on fire faces as they ran into each other. 2 girls in the back of my theater classroom would not stop talking. One of them seemed upset, so I asked them to keep it down. It continued, so I told them more firmly to pay attention. The upset girl promptly freaked out. Said, "What the duck do you want me to do? I'm duck, I'm pregnant." The entire class's mouths dropped and I couldn't think of anything to do but send her to the trauma counselor. Sure enough. Yep, one of my sophomores had a baby the April before she became a high school junior. What the duck do you want me to do? Not talk about it in the middle of class, I guess. Could be worse. I had a math class with 4 pregnant girls. They were all juniors. The kicker. One of them was pregnant with her 3rd. Now I'll get enough money from the government that I can afford to move out and get my own apartment. I wanted to throw up the day I overheard her saying that to another student. She had 3 kids before her senior year in high school. Edit. Had a math class, meaning I was teaching the math class. One of my 7th graders told me about how one of the more interesting students in our class took a dump in his hand and hid the incriminating turd in his desk. Not sure if this qualifies as juicy, but I heard this yesterday and have been looking for a place to share this lovely tidbit. Did you find that crusty turd yet? No. It was a juicy turd, bro. I teach kindergarten and they really do share everything that goes on at home. During our morning meeting, one boy shared that his uncle was arrested over the weekend and would be in jail for a long time. I was curious, so I asked what happened, and he happily told me that his uncle was making lots of fake money. Another time, a student ran up to me and was so excited, and the conversation went like this. Boy. Ems. V. My dad is so awesome. He's so talented. Me. Oh wow. That's great. What is his talent? Boy. Well, he can chug a whole bottle of beer without stopping. Sometimes he drinks all 6 beers at night. Me. Wow, that's awesome. I'm proud of him. In kindergarten, I went to school on a Monday and told my teacher that my parents got married over the weekend. I was so excited. My mom was so embarrassed when my teacher asked her about it. My parents had just renewed their vows, lol. Hahaha, that's too cute. When I was in kindergarten, my sister was dating a very shady guy. When he was in the wrong part of town trying to buy some drugs, he got shot in the butt. He did not go to the hospital to have this taken out due to not having insurance and some other issues. As a 5-year-old, this was the funniest thing ever. I was so excited to share that with my teacher. Mom was mortified. My class was the one that let our teacher know that her 37-year-old assistant had slept with a 16-year-old on prom night. Low-income area gossip. One of my students was asked by another student why the police were in front of her house for several hours the previous night. She responded that it was because her 10-year-old sister had 3 11-13-year-old boys pull guns on each other in her front yard. Apparently they were really serious about winning her over. My god. How did they even get those? My calculus teacher told us about his friend at the school he worked at before mine who got fired for having sex with a student in a dugout in broad daylight. They were found by the baseball coach. He's out. They had already made it to home base though. The student mentioned that his father went into a classroom with a fellow elementary school teacher after school hours, locked the door, and the student then wandered the halls. Student was later caught bragging to other students that his dad has sex with the teacher. Was the dad hot? Student A was talking to student B about a sex Snapchat she received. They both start giggling and talking about the person who sent the sext. It was the newly appointed assistant principal of the high school. Before taking the new position of AP, he was the girls' volleyball coach, boys' baseball coach, and the advisor slash counselor for the at-risk youth at the high school. Also turns out he was selling weed to the baseball team. Oh. And he had sexual relations with student A when she was 16 years old. I made the CPS report and told the principal. He was fired immediately and student A ended up cooperating with police and pressing charges. Not sure what happened with the court case. That story got more ducking insane as I read on. Pretty typical for these predators to take leadership roles where they are in charge of kids. The students told me that Mrs. Spanish Teacher's baby was Mr. Spanish Teacher's. They went on to tell me that the two teachers had been caught doing the nasty in the library by a student. The saddest part was that they were both married to other people. And Mr. Spanish Teacher and his wife had decided that they weren't going to have children. His wife wanted kids. He didn't, the baby had his last name. So any kid who didn't already know knew as soon as the baby was born. Don't you just hate it when the baby comes out and it doesn't have your last name? In one school, I had heard that 3 students, all minors, shot a sex tape and leaked it. Another group of students gang raped a special needs student at a school event. In another school, I heard that 2 kids were called into the office and suspended because they'd shot at each other over the weekend. The saddest was 2 girls having a conversation about how one girl's mother had remained dating a man who'd kidnapped and raped her, the mother, at gunpoint. I didn't work in a good school. Record scratch. What? Sadly, lower income areas are breeding grounds for rape and other abuse. One principal told me that she was dosed LSD by a student, putting 1 or 2 hits in her coffee, and just went about her day as normal. Attended meetings, etc. She was familiar with the experience and didn't need to go home. She waited for another day to discipline him and let him know the legal implications of what he had done and how serious the police would find it if she reported. That principal is ducking gangster lol. Sips coffee. Hum. Tastes like there is LSD in here. Continues slowly sipping coffee. Obligatory. I know there's no taste. I'm a homeroom kindergarten teacher in Beijing. Many of my students are 5 or 6 years old and are mostly all foreign children. One of my students has no English at all, and one day she keeps saying pull my hair. I ask her in Chinese, why does she keep saying pull my hair? She told me she heard it the night before at home. Straight away I think, oh my god, and then release that her mother doesn't speak English. Sometimes their maids and au pairs come to collect the children. On this specific day I wanted to talk to her father regarding something else, and lo and behold, doesn't a 20-year-old au pair with perfect English collect the poor child? Closest thing to getting juicy gossip other than trying to figure out which child ate which Claydon. Sips the tea. I teach in an elementary school. We share a PE teacher with a neighboring elementary school. This teacher told me about a group of 5th and 6th graders that all went to a nearby park and had a contest to see who was the best at giving oral. These are kids ranging from 10-12 years old. I would not want to be the administrator that had to make those phone calls home. At my school, there was some whole sexting scandal. Two kids got into a fight. Kids watching posted it on their Snapchat story. The school's police officer found out and confiscated the phones that were recording it. On those phones, they found a dong pic. Student A, male, sent this to student B, female, and B screenshotted it. After A and B broke up, B sent this to student C, male, who posted this on their story for about 10 minutes before taking this down. Keep in mind, all these kids are in 7th and 8th grade. Then, when confiscating all A, B, and C's phones, they found screenshots of student D, female, 9th grader, flashing her tits on her Instagram live stream. Then they confiscated her phone, finding a dong pic or student E. The end. How do they go through these confiscated phones? Do they demand the kids unlock them, or do kids these days not lock their phones with at least a passcode or something? When someone in authority tells a kid to do something, they will either comply or lash out, with very little middle ground. Especially if it's a principal or someone with a gun, school resource officer. In my school, when they needed to confiscate something that could be used in court, the SRO took it. 7th grade girl apparently had two dongs in her mouth in one of the back stairwells this year, and like 3 kids apparently saw it. One kid showed me a video of 2 female students making out in the bathroom. Not technically gossip, but I figure it fits. Then there's the rather infamous abandoned house down the street where the middle school gangbangs take girls to get high and then tag team them. What the duck? This is why I never had friends in middle school. About 2 other teachers who always hooked up in the teacher bathroom. It was 2 foreign teachers we had, so to the student it was extra exotic. I taught 3rd grade and had to take a mix of students with me to dismissal. A former student, let's call him B, was standing near me at dismissal. As his vehicle approaches, one of my current students, let's call him J, waves at the woman driving. I let B in the car and go back to my post. J tells me B's mom is really nice, and I ask if they are neighbors or if he plays with B after school. He shakes his head and says, my dad and his mom are friends. They're going to have a baby. I stand there confused, knowing that Jay's parents are married and had just met with me for a conference. He continues, well, we think they are having a baby, but my mom says the lady has a lot of friends and it might be E's, a student from another class. Dad, I hope it's ours. I want a sister. What? A kid basically let me know his dad was hooking up with one of the other moms, and also let me know his mom thought the lady got around. All he cared about was a sibling. Probably because he didn't grasp what the situation meant. I work with preschoolers, so the juiciest ones are. He's not invited to my birthday party. My mom has a baby in her belly. I'm gonna name it Poop. My mom has a baby in her belly. I'm gonna name it Poop. This needs to be a t-shirt for preschoolers. This girl in the preschool class I teach always tells me little random stories about her mom getting pulled over for speeding or spending time drinking with her friends. Well, last week we were on our way to a field trip and she saw a billboard for a beer company. I'm not sure what company, but it had a beer can on it, and she said very loudly, I love beer. And I said, "What?" And she repeated herself. So I said, "Stop, you're being silly." She said, "No, my daddy used to give it to me all the time. He stopped, but sometimes he gives me sips of it, and once he gave my sister a whole can." And I said, "Oh Sally, you mean root beer?" She said, "No, the beer only grown-ups drink." Inner city substitutes for a while. A girl casually dropped that her mom was getting out of prison next week. And her dad was dead. I was the student. I told my first grade teacher that one of my mom's friends played with a snake for work. At first my teacher thought it was a euphemism I'd heard and asked me privately after class what I meant. I happily explained that she was a titty dancer, a phrase my mom used, who used a boa constrictor in her dance, and that I got to meet the snake backstage. I could tell she was obviously concerned, and somehow in my brain I thought telling her, "But don't worry, she's very careful not to get her titties bit because the snake likes to eat mice." The parent-teacher conference ended up in a yelling match and a visit from CPS. So how'd that CPS visit go? It was fine. They asked me a bunch of questions about the difference in right from wrong. If I'd ever felt uncomfortable around my mom's friends. If I felt scared of her. I told them that yeah, I was scared of her, but I usually deserved my punishment. I loved my mom's friends. Especially her lesbian ones, because they had a pool and a talking bird and I clearly understood right from wrong. My mom was 16 when she had me. My dad is an addict and was rarely a part of my childhood. He's clean and we're friends now. My mom is also a high-functioning Aspie, so my childhood was strange to say the least. My mom was always honest with me, and honestly I think it's given me a much healthier opinion on sex. In my house, sex was something you could talk about. I was never ashamed to ask questions. I understood appropriate conduct. I was raped at age 12, and because I could easily discuss it. Because I understood it wasn't my fault. That I wasn't bad, I had a much easier time dealing. I never understood how some of my friends were actually afraid to talk about sex with their parents, and as a result they didn't know basics like how medication affects birth control. How tampons didn't make you not a virgin. How STDs worked. I didn't understand why anyone would be uncomfortable or ashamed of talking about a stripper. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for 3 videos a day.